3 months, Mining Review brings you news from the coalfields of Britain. It's not difficult to find your way about, even in the wildest parts of Britain. Maps, based on the work of the Ordnance Survey, tell us all about the surface of the country. But it becomes more difficult when we're breaking new ground under the surface. We should be lost without the work of another survey department, the Geological Survey. In the West Midlands, for instance, the coal seams in certain directions have come to a sudden end. Why is this? The geologists think the coal strata may have slipped deeper down. With their help, the coal board intends to find out. And so they've set up this boring rig at Hampstead, near Birmingham. For 24 hours a day, in all weather, a drill probes the West Midlands earth. Modern machinery can reach deep seams in a matter of months instead of years. As the 60-foot tubes go down into the ground, further tubes are screwed on, and the drill hole goes deeper and deeper. To find what strata are being cut through, samples are taken out in a hollow drill bit. You need a safety belt up here. The coring bit brings up a section of earth, like the lead in a huge pencil. This sample comes from over a mile down. The next step is to take it to the geologist for his opinion. He examines it and finds red sandstone, shale, bind, marl, and coal, as well as a shark fossil imprisoned in the strata thousands of years ago. When the Geological Survey's scientist has examined all the layers of earth, the coal board takes the coal part and sends it to their laboratory. Here they find out whether it's most suitable for coking, steam, household, industrial, or other uses. This test finds out its heating value. Many other tests follow. Now, the present borehole is only at the edge of the gap. The coal is there, deep down, a great seam 22 foot wide. But does it go right across? More boreholes will be sunk to find out. The whole area will be mapped. Perhaps one day, the West Midlands earth will give up millions of tons more wealth for Britain. On May the 1st, Mrs. Brown of Wandsworth got the Sunday joint ready and lit her first cubic foot of nationalised gas. Looks just the same. But all the gas in Britain was nationalised now, and with it something like 1,000 gas undertakings. Large gas works and small ones. Thousands of furnaces and millions of miles of pipework. By Act of Parliament, individual gas undertakings were formed into 12 area boards, coordinated by the Gas Council. Of course, there wasn't any difference overnight for gas workers. After all the talking, it was their job to go on making gas. As the furnaces dropped their coke, the gas drawn off was cooking Sunday dinners. Without interruption, a great changeover had taken place. And the men just carried on. And so did the machines. There would be no sudden changes, But with all Britain's fuel and power resources nationalised, future planning was to be on a national scale, as it is in the coal industry, which supplies the raw material for gas and coke. And where there are points of common interest, the gas boards are to get together with the coal board. Our gas is just the same. And it does the same job, too. But the industry belongs to us now.
Hello, sir. What are you doing?
Just helping the electrician.
I understand you've put in to go to the mechanization training center in Sheffield.
Yes.
Gordon Harper is too new to have much to say for himself. But the Sheffield Training Centre may do something for it. Here, Gordon, who has never done more than help the electrician, learns how to handle tools properly and work metal accurately to 1/1000th of an inch. After learning how to use hand tools, Gordon moves on to machines. Then on to electricity and signalling apparatus. Next on the list is flame-proof equipment. Then he takes an armature out and finds out for himself exactly how it works. All the time, theory goes hand in hand with practice. Gordon fills notebooks of information that will be useful to him for years. It isn't all work and no play at the training centre. The students have their own sports and social club and their own welfare hall. At the end of the course, Gordon comes to the really big machine, like this arc wall cutter. The students take it to pieces and put it together again, without anything left over. When they've got that far, they know their way about. Hello? Is this where we came in?
What are you doing there?
The resistance of the armoring of this cable is higher than it ought to be, so I'm just testing the earth bond to make sure of the resistance.
You'll do, son.
Frank Lax of Woomwell, Yorkshire, keeps a Greyhound. So does his friend Bernard Stale. It costs them about 18 shillings a week each, but they get into races for sixpence instead of 2 and 3 if they enter a dog. Up Lane Stadium is one of 2 tracks in Woomwell. There are 15 in South Riding alone. And after shift, Wednesday and Saturday afternoons, everybody is there. There are no prizes except for special races, but you can make something on the side. They're off. Gary's Pet is the winner. Owner, Frank Lax. And there goes someone's pay packet.
We can see